الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. إن شاء الله تعالى we'll start سورة الرحمن. سورة الرحمن سورة نمبر 55. سورة الرحمن سورة نمبر 55. من سورة الرحمن 78 verses. It's a Makki surah, according to the majority of the ulama of the tafsir. And it's actually not just a Makki surah, but of course it's a Makki surah, but it was one of the first surahs that were revealed to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. One of the very first surahs that were revealed, as it's reported by Imam Ahmad رحمه الله in his Musnad. With a sound narration from Asma bint Abi Bakr radiallahu anha, she said, سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو يصلي نحو الركن. She said, I heard the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم praying by the rukn, meaning by the Kaaba, قبل أن يصدع بما يؤمر. Before he was commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to convey the message openly. والمشركون يسمعون. And the mushrikun, the disbelievers, were listening. يقرأ فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان. And he was reciting فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان. And it was said to be revealed after, some said after Surah Al-Furqan and some said after Surah Al-Ra'd. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. And like the Makki surahs talks about, and like the previous surahs talks about matters of belief. The foundation of the religion talks about the Quran. It's the only surah in the Quran that starts with a name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like that, Ar-Rahman, which of course has a great significance to this. And the people of Quraysh, they used to deny that name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلِدْعُوا اللَّهَ أَوِدْعُوا الرَّحْمَنِ. They would not use the name Ar-Rahman attributed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is also something to be remembered. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's called Ar-Rahman because of course, how the surah starts with Ar-Rahman. Some call it Arus al-Quran, but this is not a name that was given by the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. It's more like a characteristics of the surah. Arus is usually adorned with adornments and things like this. So anyway, so but it's of course it's known to be Surah Ar-Rahman. Just one thing also, that in some cases when you might see that those who would count the verses of the Quran, sometimes there might be differences of opinions in counting the verses, and that's not something that changes anything. It's just, for example, and this is just mentioned as an example, Ar-Rahmanu 'allama al-Quran. Some consider that one verse, but it's two verses. Ar-Rahman, Allama al-Quran. But if some had considered it as to be one verse, it doesn't change anything in the Quran. So it's not like someone, when, because I heard this one time, someone was saying there are even differences of opinions of the numbers of the ayat of the Quran. Makes the person think that the ayat are not present in the Quran. No, of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserved the Quran. It's just something like this. And the same as in Surah Al-Fatiha. The last verse in Surah Al-Fatiha, is it two verses or one verses or one verse? So even though there's always a more correct opinion, but it doesn't change anything. And actually the verses were known by what the Prophet ﷺ would stop at the end of every verse. So let's get into the surah inshallah. There is, of course, the surah has great objectives, and it talks about the Quran, talks about the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One is, one of the unique things in the surah is the ayah فَبِأَيَّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ, repeated many times. And it's the way that the Quran is recited, it would give such a beautiful feel when a person is listening to the ayat. But the way it's repeated like this, every time it's repeated, it's as وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِن مُدَّكِرٍ. It has to initiate something in the heart, which is basically talks about the ala of Allah. As we will talk about that inshallah ta'ala, which is the favors of Allah, the favors of Allah, the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon the human beings. So it's in a way When you hear this, فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان, which of the favors of your Lord you deny, it's like as the ulama, they say, it's for التبكيت. When you're التبكيت is when you're condemning someone, when you're bringing the same thing with وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِنْ مُدَّكِرِ. Like, where are those who would learn the Quran? You have all the means and you're not learning the Quran. You should feel bad about not fulfilling this duty. So the same thing, in a good way, of course. And the same thing, where are those who are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and especially the disbelievers, they show the most evil when it comes to turning away from the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that ought for the person to be obedient to Allah, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. That's why when you see the surah, without going into too much of details of that, we'll go to the surah right away, inshallah. But even the way that the surah starts with what, and then afterwards, what are all of the surah is about the signs or the favors of Allah. And the most important favor at all times, is Al-Quran. Always the Quran, which is the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the purpose of this life. And more into the Quran related to the human beings, because the human beings are mentioned there. But how is the human beings the greatest favor that was given to the human being to be able to relate to the Quran and to benefit from the Quran? So we'll start, inshallah ta'ala, with the tafsir. We'll start, I'm sorry, with the recitation first. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الرحمن الرحمن علم القرآن علم القرآن خلق الإنسان خلق الإنسان علمه البيان علمه البيان الشمس والقمر بحسبان الشمس والقمر بحسبان والنجم والشجر يسجدان والنجم والشجر يسجدان والسماء رفعها ووضع الميزان والسماء رفعها ووضع الميزان ألا تطغوا في الميزان ألا تطغوا في الميزان وأقيموا الوزن بالقسط ولا تخسروا الميزان وأقيموا الوزن بالقسط ولا تخسروا الميزان إن شاء الله we'll see if we'll continue or not. الرحمن, and that's the first to be recited. So the Hamza has to be mentioned here, and it starts with the Hamza is always light. Hamza Alif A. Then the Ra is heavy. A. الرحمن. The Ha with sukun from the letters of Al Hams, here comes out. الرحمن. So don't say A, say A. الرحمن علم القرآن with the شد on the lam. علم القرآن. The ra also is heavy and the qaf is heavy. علم القرآن. خلق الإنسان. خاء فتحة. خاء لام فتحة. لا قاف فتحة. خلق. خلق not خلق. خلق لام is light. خلق. خلق and then الإنسان the noon with seen إخفاء two counts. خلق الإنسان. علمه البيان. It's easy with the شد on the lam. علمه البيان. Make sure that the noon, it's easy, but يعني just to make sure that the noon is noon at the end. So you علمه البيان. And the مد at the end of the verses, you can make it all the way to six counts. And it's because you have letter of the, what are the three letters of the mudud? Alif, waw, and ya. So if you have alif, waw, and ya, come after it hamza, we have the mudud that we make. Malaika, as-sama, whether it's in the same word or separate words. But if one of these letters are there, and then after that is a letter with sukoon, the letter after it has a sukoon, sukoon to be said, not necessarily written. So Ar-Rahman, you stop at a sukoon. So you can make it, this is mad arad al-sukoon, that means a long mad. You say Ar-Rahman, like this. Allam al-Qur'an. So there's a, you can make stretch or to make mad there. But if you connect it, then of course you don't. So Allamahu al-Bayan. Al-Shamsu wal-Qamaru bi-Husban. Al-Shamsu, the sheen from the letters of al-Intishar, Ash. الشمس والقمر but you, of course you don't make مد there just to make it you stress it الشمس والقمر the meme is the only letter that is light here in the word القمر so the, you don't say القمر القمر no القمر القمر the ra is heavy القمر القمر And these types of things, when the more you recite, the more you practice it, then it becomes easy. بحسبان, the sheen like the sheen, and here with the with sukoon, air comes out. الشمس والقمر بحسبان. والنجم, the noon with shadda, two counts, and then the jim with sukoon, قلقلة. والنجم, والنجم. والنجم والشجر يسجدان and this is where it shows the importance of the scene where the air comes out because if you're not doing giving it its right it becomes زي so not يز يس يسجدان يسجدان والنجم والشجر يسجدان والسماء that's mad رفعها the راء فتحة فاء فتحة عين فتحة هاء فتحة راء رفعها رفعها and then واو فتحة واو فتحة ضاد فتحة عين فتحة ووضع not ووا ووا and then the ضاد make sure that it does not become dal right? because you're starting light so you might continue to say the ضاد dal so ووضع ووضع رفعها ووضع الميزان والسماء رفعها ووضع الميزان الميزان والسماء رفعها ووضع الميزان. ألا شد ألا تطغوا تاء فتحة طاء سكون تاوتو سي تاء and طاء they come from the same place but one is light and one is heavy so either you say tat or tat no تاوتو تاء تاوتو تاوتو غو تاوتو غو and the غين is heavy so you continue after the ta to be heavy ألا تطغوا ألا تطغوا ألا تطغوا في الميزان. And since في هذا ياء أن الميزان هذا ياء just saying that because so that you don't skip a letter don't say ألا تطغوا في الميزان it's في الميزان في الميزان ألا تطغوا في الميزان. وأقيموا الوزن بالقسط وأقيموا الوزن بالقسط إذا قاف كسرة قي أن سين سكون قس قس and you don't have to be extreme in the قاف with كسرة make it easy it doesn't have to be that heavy so قس طي بالقسط بالقسط go back quickly to get the ta so that it's not ta ولا تخسروا that's easy ولا تخسروا ولا تخسروا الميزان وأقيموا الوزن بالقسط ولا تخسروا الميزان. It's we better if we take it all the way to فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان but it's okay because of the time inshallah we'll see. So the first ayah الرحمن which is the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala الرحمن the most beneficent and الإمام السعدي رحمه الله he said هذه السورة الكريمة الجليلة هذه السورة السورة الكريمة What's al-karima means? The al-karam from generosity, the honored. But it's either, if it's a human being, mukarram is honored, al-karima, the honored, and also comes in the meaning of generosity. We're not into the going word by word with the tafsir. But هذه سورة الكريمة الجليلة, the exalted one, افتتحها باسمه الرحمن. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started it with the name al-Rahman. Open it with the name with his name Ar-Rahman Ad-Dal ala si'ati rahmati that is evident to the spaciousness of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wa umumi ihsani and the ihsan of Allah the goodness that comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so vast that nobody can comprehend the amount of it wa jazili birri and al-birr is the righteousness and al-jazil is also the abundance wa wasi'i fadli and the fadl of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encompasses everything. And as mentioned in the tafsir of Surah Al-Fatiha, Ar-Rahman, that means everyone receives the benefit of this. If you would mention both Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, in the same context, Ar-Rahim is the special one to the believers. But Ar-Rahman is to everyone. Manu al-dunya wal-akhirah wa rahimahum wa subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Rahman of the dunya of the akhirah. Everyone receives from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the name Ar-Rahman. ثم ذكر ما يدل على رحمته. And with the tafsir, we have to make sure that we understand the meanings of things. Sometimes people, we confuse the wisdom behind using the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ar-Rahman in the first ayah. And what's the significance of that? This is not tafsir. This is not the tafsir. And this is even sometimes it goes beyond the proper way of doing things. But this is where the ulama, they call it التفسير الإشاري. Or الإشاري is الإشارة, what it signs for things like this. And you would find many of almost all the tafsir, they don't mention these things. So with the tafsir, we should stay with the meanings of things. And that's the most important thing first. And then let the heart, of course, reflect and things like this. But the Quran is to be reflected upon. And reflection or tadabbur of the Quran is to learn the meaning of it and then to put it into actions. For the person to act upon the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Quran. And that's the duty to reflect upon the Quran is upon everyone, even the disbelievers. The Quran has been revealed for them as a book of guidance. So when they're given the Quran, they have the Quran have the right upon them to reflect upon it, not just to read it and that's it, but to see what to think of, to read it and to think of what the meanings of it and to understand what is meant for them. And then this is how they receive the benefit from the Quran. So he says, ثُمَّ ذَكَرَ مَا يَدُلُّ عَلَى رَحْمَتِ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned what is evident to his rahmah, his mercy subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَأَثَرَهَا, and the effect of it. الَّذِي أَوْصَلَهُ اللَّهُ إِلَى عِبَادَهِ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it reach his servants, مِنَ النِّعَمِ الدِّينِيَّةِ وَالدُّنْيَوِي, from the ni'am, from the favors. الدِّينِيَّة, the religious ones, and الدُّنْيَوِيَّة, the worldly ones, وَالْأُخْرَوِيَّة, and the hereafter ones. That's the entire surah is like this. So the surah talks about the ni'am, the favors of Allah, the religious ones, the worldly ones, and the hereafter one. وَبَعْدَ كُلِّ جِنْسٍ وَنَوْعٍ مِّن نِعَمِهِ, and and after every jins, وَنَوْعٍ. Al-jins is the kind, like humankind. And the naw' and the type of the favor is mentioned. يُنَبِّهُ الثَّقَلَيْنِ. He brings the attention of الثَّقَلَيْنِ, the human beings and the jinn, لِشُكْرِهِ, to be grateful to Allah. So the surah, to prepare oneself, to get to recognize the favors of Allah, and the best way or the best place to recognize the favors of Allah is through the Quran, not through your own thinking even. You look at the favors of Allah and you're grateful to Allah, yes, this is an act of ubudiyyah. The best place to recognize that is from the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you would find the religious favors which comes first, which is the most important of all. Otherwise, what's the benefit of, or what's the purpose of the favors that are given in this world if people do not apply the objective of their existence, which is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the hereafter, this is the ni'am al-jaza'iyya. This is the ni'am, the recompense, as a result of them understanding the concept of the ni'am. Even you can look at it from this perspective, that humankind, if they understand the concept of the favors of Allah in the right way, they will be successful. And their misery is missing this point, whether they don't recognize that this is from Allah. And if they do, they don't become grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Therefore, they don't worship Him alone, or they disobey Him. So either they are turning away from attributing the favors to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or they recognize it, but they don't act upon it. And the surah would fix these two issues or these two diseases. If a person is sincere in coming forward to learn and benefit from the surah. And he says, and that's why when he would say, فَبِأَيَّ أَلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَ. Then the next ayah, Ar-Rahman, what's the first ayah that, or the first favor of Allah that shows the mercy of Allah? عَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنِ. عَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنِ, which means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ar-Rahman, He taught you mankind the Quran by the mercy of Allah. That's what Ar-Rahman, عَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنِ, which with the specific name and the characteristic of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most beneficent, the most merciful. So he says here, فَذَكَرَ أَنَّهُ عَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ. أي, عَلَّم. عَلَّم is when you teach someone. So he says, عَلَّمَ عِبَادَهُ. He taught his ibad, slaves of Allah, the human beings, أَلْفَاظَهُ وَمَعَانِي, the words of it and the meanings of it. وَيَسَّرَهَا عَلَى عِبَادِهِ, and he made it easy for his ibad. And we just finished again Surah Al-Qamar. وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ. And this is one of the meanings of عَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ. If a person would say, but the kuffar, they don't learn the Quran. A person does not learn the Quran. It gives the meaning also that he gave you as a human being, خلق الإنسان. He gave you as a human being all the tools, all the means to learn the Quran. So this is a favor from Allah that he gave you what he gave you from al-bayan and from the intellect and from the ability, as it's mentioned also in وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ. So where is this from your part as a human being to use what Allah gave you to learn the wahi, the revelation from Allah? And if a person is not using it with whatever level that he's in, he's not doing good for himself. You're given something for something. So you're given a tool to use it for your job. But instead of using it for your job, you just put it aside and you don't learn from it anything. And therefore you won't fulfill your job. So here, as the tafsir says, عَلَّمَ عِبَادَهُ, he taught his ibad, أَلْفَاظَهُ وَمَعَانِي. If someone reads the Quran, you will understand the meaning. أَلْفَاظَهُ وَمَعَانِي. وَيَسَّرَهَا, he made it easy for them. وَهَذَا أَعْظَمُ مِنَّةٍ وَرَحْمَةٍ رَحِمَ بِهَا عِبَادًا. This is the greatest favor of Allah and mercy from Allah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon his creation. And this is a matter of belief. So let whoever think otherwise, if someone reads the Quran, someone believes in the Quran, what is the biggest favor? Like the early generations of Islam, they used to, when they talk about the aqidah that it comes, especially when deviation happened, like they would say it like the talqeen. Talqeen, it is sufficient to ask them, what's your aqidah? Now, if someone asks you, what's your aqidah? Say, aqidah in what? Tell me and I'll answer you. No, they would say, what's your aqidah? So he would list his aqidah. From the perspective of the people of Ahl Sunnah, what makes them from the people of Ahl Sunnah. So here, the same thing, when a person knows as a matter of conviction, what is the best favor that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allama al-Quran? The best favor is this Quran. Imagine this world without the Quran. Miserable world. Imagine this life does not have the Quran in it. And that's why it's the duty to give the nasiha and the concern towards others, because they're missing the most beautiful thing in this life, and which is the book of Allah. So حيث أنزل عليهم قرآنا عربيا بأحسن الألفاظ, brought down unto them the Quran in the Arabic language with the best of words, وأحسن تفسير, and the best explanation, مشتمل على كل خير, زاجر عن كل شر. It includes every خير, every goodness, and it's زاجر, remember مزدجر, زاجر, that means it pushes away from every evil. And the evil are not mentioned just as it's evil, but it gives you the meanings of, it gives you the push away, that the way of the Quran, nothing is better than the way of the Quran. قُلْ إِنَّمَا أُنذِرُكُمْ بِالْوَحِي. Indeed, I warn you by the wahi. So if you want to forbid an evil from someone, you want to say something to someone to make them realize how evil they're doing so that they turn away from it, use the way of the Quran, because it has the best way of zajr. And the same thing when it comes to what's good, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed it for people to be upon it. So allama al-Quran, as the al-Hasan, and this is some of the things to also enrich the meaning of it, as we said, learn the alfaz wal-ma'ani, the words and the meanings, make it easy for the people to learn. Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah, he said, al-nutq. Allama al-Quran, that he gave you the ability to speak, which makes the human beings unique. They're able to speak, which is also allamahu al-bayan. He's able to express what's inside of him. You want something? Imagine that you're not able to express what you want or what you want to say. So this is just for the fact that the person is able to speak, for what? So that they would be able to learn the Quran, which is al-bayan, which is al-nutq. And how al-bayan in the context of the Quran, and to recite the Quran. And that's the best favor for a person is able to speak so that he can read the Quran, and to use the ability that we can say things, to use it for learning the Quran. So allama al-Quran, that means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught the human beings al-Quran. The word علم here, and also علمه البيان. علم with a shadda, that means he taught, that means someone else learned. Because some, hamukallah, علم القرآن is not just informed them that there is something called the Quran. No, علم is more than that. Because informing, you would have an alif. أعلمته, when you say أعلمت فلان كذا, أعلمته, that means I made him know or I informed them of something. Versus علمته, right? علمته, that means I taught him. أعلمته, I just gave him the news. So علم القرآن is how the Quran is to be taught. And that's all from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. خلق الإنسان, which is means he created the human beings. He says في أحسن تقويم, in the best image, in the best way. كامل الأعضاء, with his organs, in the most perfect way to fulfill his job. مستوفي الأجزاء, different, every different part is for its place. محكم البناء, البناء is the structure, محكم, very well structured. قد أتقن البديع تعالى خلقه, أي إتقان. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perfected, and he is al-badi' subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-badi', one of the names of Allah, that means he created things without a previous example. And human beings, they only say or learn or things based on a previous example that they have. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the initiator of all things, and he created him in the most perfect way. Whether al-insan here is Adam alayhi salam, or the offspring, Adam and his offsprings, this is all correct. So whether it's the humankind or the original form of the human beings, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam alayhi salam, it's all correct. So خلق الإنسان. So the first one is علم القرآن, and then خلق الإنسان علمه البيان, which means he taught him البيان, which is the eloquent speech. Not necessarily eloquent speech, but it's البيان. That means the ability to make matters clear. Not clear, yeah. When something is al-bayan, from something is hidden, and then it becomes clear or apparent. As he says here, وَمَيَّزَهُ عَلَى سَائِرِ الْحَيَوَانَاتِ. The favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he gave the human beings what he didn't give the rest of the hayawanat, the animals, or the creation of Allah, and عَلَّمَهُ الْبَيَانِ. That he taught him al-bayan. What is al-bayan? التبيين عما في ضميري. التبيين, to make things clear with what in his ضمير, in his conscience. So you have something in your conscience, and how to express that, this is al-bayan. وهذا شامل, that includes بالتعليم, in matters of تعليم النطقي, تعليم النطقي with one speech, والتعليم الخطي, to learn how to write. فالبيان الذي ميز الله به الآدمي على غيره من أجل نعم. So البيان that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the human beings other different than anyone else is one of the greatest favors of Allah. If, again, it becomes a nikmah, it becomes a punishment if a person uses it for evil. But if it's used to learn the Quran and to be obedient to Allah. And this is also وعلم آدم الأسماء كلها. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught Adam alayhi salam all the names. And also, you can go on with this, as the ulama would say in the tafsir, as there's a statement from Abdullah ibn Abbas is attributed to him, that خلق الإنسان علمه البيان, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught him الحلال والحرام. So any matter, أو الهدى من الضلال, and guidance from deviation, and what's going to be, and what's in the past, all of that is part of the bayan, and the ability to understand, the ability to comprehend. So it goes on and on with the meaning of al-bayan. علمه البيان. And these three verses, if it requires definitely lots of understanding, lots of reflection and application also, because these favors, if we look at it from the subject of, again, at-tabkeet, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, علم القرآن خلق الإنسان. It's an obvious thing why it's mentioned. you know, that you're Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you and made you, gave you the ability to express yourself. You know that. But what is then the outcome of this? Why you're not using it in the way it ought to be? Why you're not learning the Quran? Why you're not obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He gave you these things and these means to prepare you or to set you for whatever He created you for? And then shamsu wal qamaru bi husban, which means the sun and the moon run on their fixed courses. Wal shamsu wal qamaru bi husban ay khalaq Allah shamsa wal qamar, that means also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the sun and the moon. Wasakharahuma, He subjected them, yajriyan, they move, they bihisabin muqannan, with a very specific calculation, wa taqdeerin muqaddar, they don't have a choice, they are by the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Shamsu yana shamsu yanbaghi laha an tudrika al-qamar, jazakumullahu khair, wa la laylu sabiqu an-nahar, shams does not befit for the shams, for the sun to surpass the moon. Everything has a specific calculation for it, measures. Rahmatan bil ibad, this is mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the people. Wa inayatan bihim, taking care of them, maintaining their life. Wa liyakuma bidhalika mimma salihim ma yakum, and for the benefits that they would receive as a result of this. Wa liya'rif al ibad, as mentioned in the Quran, some of the benefits, to know the adad al sanina wal hisab, to know the count of the years, and al hisab, and calculations and things like this. So they don't have the shams wal qamar, and that is related to the human beings. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the shams wal qamar, and they don't do anything, but they follow the commands of Allah. They don't have what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the human beings. So what the human beings, they need to do is to willingly do what, as if they have no choice, which is basically the willingness to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when it comes to the deen of Allah. Ash-shamsu wal-qamaru bi-husban, with every single hisab, with measures. Wal-najmu wal-shajaru yasjudan. Al-najm here, as says, and the herbs or stars, and the trees both prostrate. Wal-najmu wal-shajar. Al-najm, the word al-najm, when you hear the word al-najm, the first thing comes into your mind is the stars, which is correct. Wal-najmi idha hawa, as we heard in the surah. Also, one of the meanings of al-najm is the herbs or the plants that doesn't have a stem. So the things that does not have a stem, it's called najm. And why some said that this is the herbs or the plants that doesn't have a stem? Because it says wal-najmu wa-shajar. Al-shajar are the ones that have stems. So the trees, so wal-najmu wa-shajar, because they're both together from the same kind, they both yasjudan, they both make sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, as he hear what we are having in the tafsir, nujumus sama, the nujum in the skies, wa ashjarul ard, so the stars in the skies and the trees on the earth, ta'rifu rabbaha, it knows its Lord, ta'rifu rabbaha wa tasjud lahu, it makes sujood to Allah. It makes sujood to Allah, that means it knows its Lord, and it makes sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa tuti', and it's obedient, wa takhsha' wa tanqad, and devoted, and in state of submission, lima sakharaha lahu min masalihi ibadi wa manafi', for what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created them for, and the benefits of the human beings. So every creation of Allah knows its Lord, and it knows what's it created for, and it does not do anything except what has been created for. As we know the hadith in Sahih Muslim, when the cow, someone rode over a cow, riding a car to a cow, like a horse, the cow spoke. He said, "Nali hada khulqt," I was not created for this. So the cow knows what it's been created for. You look at the cow, doesn't speak, and the human beings, they speak. So if the cow was given the ability to al-bayan, and it was given as a miraculous thing for a moment for the human beings to get this miraculous meaning, if they were given that, everything will become clear. You would see how everything knows what's the purpose of its creation, and it's following it. But they don't have to be given al-bayan to do this, because you see them. You don't see the sun refuses to come out one day because it's tired or doesn't have this, doesn't want to do this. Or the animals, they do something else other than what they created for. Everything is created for a reason, and that's you put that with al-bayan that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the human beings, and instead of them knowing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created them for, they make the tughyan and the transgression, which is given by the permission of Allah, meaning He gave them that ability, and not that He left them. This is what makes the human beings unique. As the angels, when they said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أَتَجْعَلُ فِيهَا مَا يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا وَيَسْفِكُ الدِّمَاءِ وَنَحْنُ نُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِكَ وَنُقَدِّسُ لَكَ. You will create in it, you will make on the face of earth those who would spread corruption and shed blood while we glorify your name and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala constantly. قَالَ إِنِّي أَعْلَمُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I know what you do not know. So what's given to the human beings in this limited time that they live on the face of earth, they're given the choice whether to spread corruption and to shed blood and to do evil or to follow the rest of the creation of Allah, which they know what they're created for. So what you have been created for, oh, you human being? You know that the cow is created for this, the camels are created for this, the trees are created for all of these benefits. We see it when we acknowledge it, even if a person is reminded of. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of all of this, and He gave them a purpose and they're doing it. Then where is your purpose? And most of the human beings, they don't care. They're not using the means that Allah gave them to understand their purpose. They have a purpose. How would they know their purpose? If they're given the choice to be good or evil, that means they need to have something external to show them the purpose. Otherwise, what's the uniqueness of the human beings? And this is where the importance of the wahi. This is the revelation from Allah. So they have to have that external guidance. So, and what is present in their life is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent messengers and revealed books for that test to be established. So al-najmu wa-shajaru yasjudan, they make sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They know their Lord and they make sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We can stop here, inshallah, even though we still need to continue, but because of the time, and it's the day of Jum'ah. So the verses, knowing the meaning of it, and to apply what the verses are implying, this is the duty that we need to be upon. And as again, as some of the ulama, they mentioned, all of these favors, when you, Qayyim mentioned beautiful kalam about this subject also. Muhasabatu nafs in muhasabah, when you're putting yourself in accountability to make muhasabah to yourself, how do you do this? People think of, okay, did I do this right? And that before you go to sleep, make sure that you make muhasabah to yourself. There's no fixed way of doing this, but the way to perfect it is that you see the favors of Allah. You cannot make muhasabah to yourself unless you see the favors of Allah, and then you see how are you with the favors of Allah. Then you would see how deficient and weak, and how we are in need of the repentance of Allah with every breath we take. But this is how to make oneself accountable for their actions. And without even, once you get to know the favors of Allah, that brings this tabkeet again, that you as a human being humble yourself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be obedient to Him, worship Him alone, see how the creation of Allah and every word is meant. Why when najmu wa-shajaru yasjudan? In this context of they are creation of Allah, but yasjudan shows their actions and that full submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then the justice will be mentioned, words or verses that is sufficient for the people to recognize this, and then they act according to the wahy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us this understanding and to purify our hearts with the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the love of Allah. We'll stop here, inshallah. Sallallahu sallam, baraka Muhammad, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Inshallah, the exam would not include Surah Al-Rahman, inshallah. So till the end of Surah Al-Qamar, as I said again, memorization and the tafsir, they're not necessarily going together. If you want, mashallah, this is perfect. That's what is, mashallah, is good. But it's not something that would make you of a lower grade, for example. Meaning that, inshallah, the goal is to recite from memory from Surah Qaf till the end. So do whatever you have of the means that you have, as long, again, if you don't recite every week, yes, this is a problem. And if we have the means, we will force everyone. But we should be forced from our own selves to make sure that we recite every week, inshallah. And again, وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ. How can we apply this if we just be like everyone else? It doesn't have to be fard, by the way. Right? We don't have to make it, this is fard. Okay, if it's not, someone will say, is it fard? We're not talking about fard. But if it's the ayah says this, we have to have something. So that means one ayah a week, who can say, I'm not able to memorize one ayah a week? I don't think anyone would say that. So recite one ayah a week. Inshallah, don't say it's embarrassing. It's ilm. Ilm is ibadah. Would you say it's embarrassing for me to come for salah while I'm not ready for it or something of that nature? It's not about human beings. It's about worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So there's no such a thing as being embarrassed when it comes to seeking knowledge. And one of which is memorizing the Quran. One verse a week is sufficient, inshallah. The minimum requirement, inshallah. But that doesn't make it only one verse. We should make it the best we can, inshallah. So that we have more of the Hafaz to help us with the testing, inshallah. Barakallahu feekum. Sallallahu sallam. Barakallahu Muhammad wa sallam. سبحانك اللهم ربنا وبحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا انت استغفرك واتوب اليك